I'll be giving advice to y'all. I know I look a mess right now, but I'm not just gonna be giving advice to y'all. I'm gonna be getting ready. I'm talking about my whole entire makeup routine that y'all been asking for, my skincare routine, all that in one video. So advice, skincare, and makeup in one video. Y'all should be happy. I look a mess right now, but that's really not the point. I'm just here to be giving y'all advice because, I mean, that's what y'all asked for, and what y'all asked for, y'all shall receive. So that's what I'm gonna give y'all. But before we start this video, make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Don't mind this pimple, it's gonna go away in a couple of days. But yeah, let's just get on with this video. All right, y'all, so I'm gonna just, like, I wrote down the questions, like, some of y'all asked on my iPad. So I'm gonna just, like, read it out while I'm doing my makeup and stuff. Y'all probably can't see my makeup, but I'm gonna stop and show y'all and stuff so y'all could, like, kind of get, like, the point. But the first one is how to get out of a toxic relationship. To be honest, if you're not feeling the relationship, you have to think about, like, yourself. Like, do I really want this relationship? Is it worth going through this so I could have the relationship I want? If your answer is no, then you need to get out of it. I mean, and it's not even how you do it, it's when you do it. Because, like, it's easy to get out of a relationship you don't want. If you don't like the situation you're in, you could easily get out of it. And I'm not talking about, like, if it's abusive. If it's abusive, don't ask me for that, any type of advice. Because if it's abusive, you need to, like, I don't even know. You need to call somebody, tell them that you're getting abused. But if this is, like, toxic, like, y'all arguing every other day and stuff like that, like, little kid type of stuff like that, okay, that's easy. Like, talk it out with your partner at first, and if it doesn't work out and the same stuff keeps happening again, y'all need to work out, see how, if y'all gonna fix it. And if y'all not gonna fix it, y'all need to just end it there and find somebody else. I mean, and it, like, it sounds easy, and I know that y'all be like, oh yeah, it's hard, I'm never gonna find nobody else. But y'all will. There's like 7 billion people in this whole entire world. And I know y'all be like, but I want this one, I want this one. Well, if it's not gonna work, what you gonna do? Exactly. There's really nothing that you really can do, because it's like, what? But y'all, anyways, the first thing that I start off with my Cetaphil face wash. I just put it in my hand. Y'all know how the container look, because I showed y'all, like, plenty of times. But yeah, I'm gonna wash my face and I'll get back to y'all. Let's move on to the next question, because I just got finished washing my face. So let's go on to the next question, because I just finished the first question for y'all. That question was really easy, if you want me to be for real, because it's not like I deal with toxic relationships. Well, relationships wise, yeah, but it's not like boyfriend girlfriend type stuff. It's like with my friends and stuff, like me forgiving them, knowing that they did me wrong in the past when I should have just left them. And it's like, you're not supposed to, I'm not saying like giving a person another chance is like wrong, but it's like after that one chance and you feel like they did you wrong, like it depends on what they did. Like if they did you, like, it's not even that. I don't know how to explain it, guys. Like, if they did something that you know that you wouldn't do to them, then, yeah, it's time to leave that person alone. Because, like, if you wouldn't do that to them, why would they do that to you? Unless they're weird and they move weird. So, you need to cut them off. Anyways, next question. How to deal with stress? If you want me to be for real, if it's, like, school, any type of stress, if you want me to be for real, y'all need to go on y'all notes app. This is what I do literally every single day. I go on my notes app. Wait, pause. Let me tell y'all what I'm about to use. I use baby oil gel to moisturize my face. But anyways, let's get on with this question. So go to your notes app. If you like have a iPhone, if you don't have an iPhone, you have like an Android or something, just get a journal. Find a book, get a pencil, and write down what's stressing you out. If you write it all out and you figure out how to get through it and stuff, you won't be stressed out. Because if you don't really have nobody to talk to and you start writing out what's stressing you out, it's like you're talking to somebody. And I know it might sound crazy, but trust me, it's going to work. And don't ever let nobody call you crazy for that, because it's not crazy. It's just saying, like, what you gotta do in order to get through whatever you're going through. Even if it's stress at home, stress at school, stress anywhere. Like, what? But, yeah, that's pretty much how you get through stress. You pray to God. You could literally do anything that you want to do if you want to be free. To get through stress is, like, easy. I mean, it's not, like, super easy. Don't get me wrong. Because some stress is, like, very difficult. But, besides that, just do what I say, and it, like, it really helps, like, and y'all don't have to do what I say, but I'm just saying, like, it would literally help, because it helps me, and I go through stress a lot, but I'm not saying, my stress is not really bad. I don't really have to worry about really anything. I mean, there's some bad days for me, but it's not, like, anything, like, horrible, like, some other people might be going through. But anyways, next question. How to respond to, like, haters or negative people in your life that you know or don't know? To be honest, I deal with this a lot. Like, growing up throughout my whole entire life, going up through school, like, I had so many people jealous of your girl. Like, what? Obviously, if you have people jealous of you, that's good. You're not, like, if you don't have people jealous of you wanting to take your spot, then you're doing something wrong. And I mean that by literally, like, I'm being for real. Like, if you don't have people hating on you, you're most definitely doing something wrong, and you need to fix whatever you're doing wrong, because it's not going to work out. Anyways, like I said, if you have people, like, hating on you or whatever, just ignore it, because that's what they really want you to do, is entertain them. That's what they really want. And sometimes I know, like, it may be hard, because it's very hard for me to, like, ignore people. But to be honest, if you have, like, haters, they really truly cared and love that person. But it's just, like, if you're seeing that person doesn't like you anymore, they don't want you, they're taking you for granted, they're treating you like you really not that girl, and you know that you are that girl, then why are you still with them? Like, I feel like the best thing for you is to move on, not even find somebody new, because that's what people think that they're supposed to do. They jump out of a relationship that they really, like, cared about, and they go find something new, and they end up not finding nothing new in that other person, because that's not where you're supposed to be going. You're supposed to focus on yourself first. You cannot love nobody else, and you cannot get love from anybody else if you don't love yourself. And I feel like people really don't believe in that, but I really believe in that, because if you don't love yourself, nobody else will. And that's literally the most important thing that you have to remember about relationships. Always, I mean, I'm not saying, like, and y'all be thinking it's selfish to put yourself first. No, it's not selfish to put yourself first. Like, because if you don't put yourself first and you always put everybody else first, oh, if I do this, he, she, or what's the name would get mad. It don't matter what what's the name think, because what's the name is not you. What's the name doesn't live your life. What's the name is not going to, like, die with you. You have to remember who's gonna be with you your entire life. Not everybody stays and not everybody goes, but it's just, like, nothing lasts forever, so you always have to put yourself first if you want me to be for real. And that's just on some, like, real stuff. Like, and I know it's hard, y'all know, y'all probably saying, like, this girl don't know what she's talking about, she's a little girl. But it's just, like, I know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about. Trust and believe me. Because I had some people, like, try to tell me, oh, if you put yourself first, well, they try to make it seem like if I put myself first, then I'm being selfish. Or if I think about what's going to happen to me instead of what's going to happen with them, then I'm being selfish. That's not selfish at all. You're just thinking about what's going to happen in the later situation. But that's not the point. The next thing I do in my makeup routine is I add my Lash Paradise, makeup. And I'm probably not going to finish my makeup routine because I just literally spent this whole time, like, talking to y'all. But it's fine. As long as I was able to give y'all, like, advice, it really doesn't really matter to me. But, next question. The next question is, It's about friendship. This next question is about friendship, and I like dealing with friendship. If I go to a new school, it said, if I go to a new school, what should I be focusing on? To be honest, if you go to a new school and you're by yourself, I'm not going to say you have to be like a loner. Do not get me wrong. Some people do not like being loners, or they don't like being quiet or whatever. And I'm not even saying like you have to do that, but mind your business. That's all I would say. Mind your business. Stay out the way. Don't be in the mix, because if you be in the mix, you're going to end up getting yourself into something. And it's just like, you're not going to know who's your friend or not. Your friends are going to come pass through and out your life. And you won't even know who's your real friend if you just stay in the drama, stay in the mix. Because a lot of people really don't have your back. And I don't care how many people be like, oh yeah, I got you. We for life, we locked in. It doesn't matter. People really don't have your back. And you really have to learn that at a young age. And I learned that at a young age when I was in school. Dang, I'm studying a lot. But yeah, I learned that at a young age when I was in school. I learned that like recently. What am I talking about? Yeah, I learned that recently. Like, not everybody is your friend, first of all. So if you go to a new school, make sure you don't just be trusting anybody. Make good decisions, like real good decisions. Is she worth fighting? Is she worth even being my friend? Is she worth even getting like my attention? Ask yourself questions like that. Because now that I look back at it, that's something that I should have asked myself. So I'm just giving y'all advice, because it's really, this world is crazy, if you want me to be for real. Like, y'all don't even understand. But thank y'all so much for watching this video. I cannot go on with my makeup routine. I didn't have enough time. My dumb self just was talking the whole entire video. And I know y'all don't want like a super, super, duper, duper long video. So I'm just giving y'all what it is. And yeah, thank you guys for watching this video. If y'all think my advice is valid, comment valid under the comments. Love y'all so much. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Go follow my Instagram. My Instagram will be in the description below. And I love y'all. Stay tuned for the next video. Bye, y'all.